Good evening and welcome, my dear friends, to Wednesday evening prayer. It is the traditional divine office of Vespers. For those who may not be familiar with this prayer, it's the prayer that's recited by all monastics, nuns and religious men and women in the Catholic Christian tradition around about this time. And I pray that you will join me. But this evening, we've lit our light and we're going to remember a dear friend of our community, Brother Ron, who's been a lifelong friend and member for a number of years, and his dear father passed away at home with Brother Ron present last evening. So we remember our dear brother, who loved his father dearly and who did everything for him for the last few years. So it'll be a great wrench and a relief. So, Father, Mother, God, we call upon you now and we ask your blessing on all here present. Allow your Holy Spirit come into us and let our time of celebration be a time of joy in service to your love. Amen. And now we ring our little bells, our Tibetan bells, calling on the Spirit of God. And we welcome our dear sister Sue and brother Liam on our live stream channel. And we welcome dear Mary, who's with us. And lovely to have you with us, Mary, on Facebook. And of course, Albert Monolas, welcome too. So we gather now as we come into the presence of love to recite the office of Vespers. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And our hymn this evening isn't the hymn for Wednesday Vespers. It's from a beautiful hymn book, Sing Your Faith, from the Unitarian Fellowship. And it's hymn number 160, and the theme, the highest goodness. The highest goodness is like water, and which by name great way we call, finds all the places which we can't reach, and without effort waters all. All plants and fruits and crops are needful, as also is our staple grain. Of showers of water and of monsoon, which falls on fields from clouds of rain. But sometimes rains are not forthcoming and life on earth seems strangely cursed. So many we manage water fairly and learn to put the green earth first. And I've just realized we said that this morning. So, guided by Spirit again, we read hymn number 161, forgive me. I guess it's the sun, it gets to you. The human touch is the theme of this hymn. The human touch can light the flame, which gives a brightness to the day. The Spirit uses mortal flame, life's vehicle for work and play. The lover's kiss, the friend's embrace, the clasp of hands to show we care, the light of welcome on the face, our treasured moments all can share. May all who come within our reach be kindled by our inner glow, not just in Spirit's words we preach, in human touch, love's faith we show. That's by John Andrew Story, born in 1935, and who crossed over in 1997, may he rest in peace. And now for the first antiphon for the Office of Vespers for Wednesday evening. Now, here we are. The Lord is my light and my help, whom shall I fear? And now we read Psalm 26 from the Old Testament Bible. The Lord is my light and my help, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, before whom shall I shrink? When evildoers draw near to devour my flesh, it is they, my enemies and foes, who who stumble and fall. Though an army encamp against me, my heart would not fear. Though war break out against me, even then would I trust. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold his temple. For there he keeps me safe in his tent in the day of evil. He hides me in the shelter of his tent. On a rock he sets me safe. And now my head shall be raised above my foes who surround me, and I shall offer within his tent a sacrifice of joy. I will sing and make music for the Lord. Let us now pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Lord is my light and my help, whom shall I fear? And the second antiphon, it is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. And we continue with Psalm 26. O Lord, hear my voice when I call. Have mercy and answer. Of you my heart has spoken. Seek his face. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. Dismiss not your servant in anger. You have been my help. Do not abandon or forsake me, O God, my help. Though father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Instruct me, Lord, in your way. On an even path, lead me. When they lie in ambush, protect me from my enemies' greed. False witnesses rise against me, breathing out fury. I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in him, hold firm, and take heart. Hope in the Lord. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. It is your face, O Lord, that I seek. Hide not your face. And the third antiphon, he is the firstborn of all creation. He is supreme over all creatures. And our next reading is a canticle reading from St. Paul to the Colossians. Let us give thanks to our Father, Mother God, who has qualified us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. He has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of their beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sin. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him all things were created in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible. All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together for good. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in everything he might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. Let us now pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. He is the firstborn of all creation. He is supreme over all creatures. And now we have a short reading, a scripture reading from St. John. You must do what the word tells you and not just listen to it and deceive yourselves. But the man or woman who looks steadily at the perfect law of freedom and makes that their habit, not listening and then forgetting, but actively putting it into practice, will be happy in all that they do. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the short responsory, redeem me, Lord, and show me your mercy. Redeem me, Lord, and show me your mercy. Do not cast me away with sinners. Redeem me, Lord, and show me your mercy. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. Redeem me, Lord, and show me your mercy. And now we have our magnificent antiphon. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And it's at this time, every evening when we come to say Vespers, we begin with the Magnificat, the beautiful canticle of Mary, Mary's response to the Archangel Gabriel, who appeared to her to announce to her the good news that she would give birth to the Messiah. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, who is my Savior. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in prayers. He puts forth his arm in strength, and he scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones, and he exalts the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, and he sends the rich away empty-handed. He protects Israel, his servant. That's you and me, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers Abraham and his sons forever. Let us now pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The Almighty has done great things for me. Holy is his name. And now we come to our evening intercessions, where we pray with one another for each other. The world is ablaze with the glory of God, who cares for his chosen people with infinite love. In the name of all faiths we pray, Lord, show your love to all men and women. Lord, show your love to all men and women. Be mindful of your church, keep her free from evil, and make her perfect in your love. Response, Lord, show your love to all men and women. Let all peoples acknowledge that you alone are God, the God of many names and none, and that Jesus Christ is your Son. Give them the light of faith. Response, Lord, show your love to all men and women. Grant to those around us all that they need, so that they may know thankfulness to live in peace. Response, Lord, show your love to all men and women. Keep us mindful of those whose work is hard and unrewarded. May we give every man and woman the respect which is their right. Response, Lord, show your love to all men and women. Give peace to those who have died today. Grant them eternal rest. Response, Lord, show your love to all men and women. And we remember especially our dear brother Ron in Liverpool, whose father passed away last evening. His dad had been quite poorly for some time, in and out of hospital, but thankfully he had his wish and he died at home with his son. So we give thanks, and Lord, have mercy on his soul and give strength to dear brother Ron. Amen. And now, just for a moment, let us bring our own requests to God. I have a list as long as my arm, but it's best to focus on the one that's important. And here I want to bring all the many requests that we receive that's in our intercession book, too many to mention. but we pray especially for Emma Hepburn's daughter, Jemima, who's got anorexia. We remember Sister Dina in Florida, who struggles with a lot of health issues, and we pray that all the medical help will be given for the diagnosis when it's finally given to Dina. And we pray for Linda in England, a Franciscan sister, that her scan results are okay. We pray for the many in this book, and we ask the Lord God to touch each and every one of them. We pray for our dear Mary O'Donnell from Cork in Ireland, who's joined us on Facebook. Dear Mary, bless you. But we also remember Maggie, and we remember Siobhan, Daniel McCabe. We remember Caroline Burt, dear Caroline, whom we remember from the Isle of Wight, who's always been there as a Twitter friend. And it's important that we give thanks to God for Caroline, who's such a brave soul. And we give thanks for her faith and her courage against many obstacles, but she's on the right side now. And we pray for David, Louis, we pray for Albert, and we pray for and for Mary, and for all those who will join us at a later time on Facebook. I want to pray this evening for our dear Sister Sue's friend, Pat, and pray that the diagnosis is good and the treatment is there. We pray for Sister Pam, who's joined us on our live stream channel from California. Good morning, dear Sister Pam. And for Brother Liam in London, who's joined us here. So let us now bring our requests to God. Let's name them. They're ours. Let us bless them, and let us give them to God in a mindset of gratitude and love. And the secret to having your prayers answered by God is to leave them with God in trust and just to say, thank you, God. And not to go on repeating and repeating over and over for the same thing, because that reveals that you do not trust in God. So do it once and leave it with God. And now let us pray those requests to God. And this evening, I want to pray for all our religious leaders, especially for our Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray also for His Holiness, the Dalai Lama, for Thich Nhat Hanh, for Queen Elizabeth, our reigning monarch, a truly amazing lady. And we pray for the whole Anglican Communion, of which she is sovereign head. But we pray for all the men and women down through the centuries who've dedicated their life to God, the God of many names and none, and for the brothers and sisters in our own community around the world who live a very simple life, following in the footsteps of St. Francis of Assisi, and of course the Barefoot Galilean. And they live this life and they dedicate their heart to God for interspiritual unity, that the whole family of God will unite with respect, with tolerance and compassion, and leave judgment to God. But we also pray for peace in this beautiful world, the Cathedral of God. So now we pray from the heart, the prayer that Jesus gave us, but we're going to pray from the original version of the Aramaic. And it is really a beautiful prayer. O birther, father, mother of the cosmos, focus your light within us, make it useful. Create your reign of unity now. Your one desire then acts with ours, as in all light, so as in all forms. Grant what we need each day in bread and insight, Loose the cords of mistakes binding us as we release the strands we hold of others' guilt. Don't let surface things delude us, but free us from what holds us back. From you is born all ruling will, the power and the life to do, the song that beautifies all, from age to age it renews. Truly power to these statements, may they be the ground from which all our actions grow. Amen. Isn't that a beautiful translation from the original Lord's Prayer that was in Aramaic? And that would have been the language of Jesus. So now, instead of a farewell prayer, my heart is guided to play a tune and dedicate it to you. And I'm going to play this beautiful one now, an Irish blessing. We played it this morning, but I want to play it again because it really moved my heart. So an Irish blessing by Roma Downey for each one of you, thanking Almighty God for your gift of presence here and accelerating God's love and peace in this beautiful world.
May the blessing of light be upon you, light on the outside, light on the inside. With God's sunlight shining on you, may your heart glow with warmth like a turf fire that welcomes friends and strangers alike. May the light of the Lord shine from your eyes like a candle in the window, welcoming the weary traveler. May the blessing of God's soft rain be on you, falling gently on your head, refreshing your soul with the sweetness of little flowers newly blooming. May the strength of the winds of heaven bless you, carrying the rain to wash your spirit clean, sparkling after in the sunlight. May the blessing of God's earth be on you, and as you walk the roads, may you always have a kind word for those you meet. Understand the strength and power of God in a thunderstorm in winter, and the quiet beauty of creation in the calm of a summer sunset. And may you come to realize that, insignificant as you may seem in this great universe, you are an important part of God's plan. Thank you. May he watch over you and keep you safe from harm.
Dear friends, is our parting gift to you from the hearts and spirit of all our brothers and sisters in our community. And what way to end Vespers than the Irish blessing? So in the presence of the God of many names and none, we give thanks for the Lord Jesus Christ, touching all our hearts in the presence of the God of many names and none. And we thank God for enriching your lives with the gift of God's peace this night and every night you live. Amen. So go in peace to love and to serve our God. Namaste, Shalom, Inshallah, Pax et Bonum, OmShanti. Solo di caritas, salam alaikum, and may the peace of your God, Goddess, reawaken in your heart that you are an ambassador of peace for God. Till we meet again, hopefully tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. and tomorrow evening at 5 p.m. But have a wonderful evening or a wonderful morning or afternoon, wherever you may be in the world. God bless you and keep you safe and well. Amen.